getting too old for this nonsense. I'm getting too old for this nonsense.
Hey all, ShadowHarvester is here at Kesaroy Lake, the inlet actually. So you're probably wondering what we're doing here. Well, I'm actually going to evolve some Pokémon. So, yeah, let's show off them uns. We got Slowking, Scizor, which are actually both trade evolutions for, of course, Slowpoke and Scyther, respectively. Slowking comes actually from, it's traded from Pokemon Go Home to Violet, and Scizor is actually from Legends Arceus. So, yeah. So, Ginesti, Ganork, Frostbite, Cloud9, and Lightning are all going to evolve. I managed to actually do something that I should have done when we were originally making those videos, where I evolved all the other stuff for whatever reason. I actually leveled them up to the point where they need to evolve. Now, some of them over-level, but, you know, that's all good. And some have either just one stage to go. Others have two stages to go to evolve, so we'll keep them on the team until then. Alright. And Slowking and Scizor are just here, just in case something goes wrong. Yeah. Because something always goes wrong when you plan something. You know? I don't really have Pokemon that are super effective, and I've used plenty of Pokemon that helped out for this, not just Slowking and Scizor. We had quite a few Pokemon helping out, and we'll probably end up using some of them to help take care of this. Alright, Slowking was actually pretty much the main mon I used to do this, and for some reason I did it here because you get level 50 stuff. Alright, Ganork is evolving! Like it should be. Who doesn't love this, actually? Because, you know, Grimmsnarl was actually a Pokemon I used in the Sword playthrough, so yeah. Spirit Break, yeah, you know what? Yeah, might as well. And yes, Frostbite's evolving too. Of course, a male snow runt has to become Glalie. Oh yeah. It prevents prey from escaping by instantaneously freezing moisture in the air. Congratulations. And you want to learn freeze dry, huh? What move should we get rid of? Let's get rid of frost breath. You got a minty frosty breath. Okay, with that out of the way, our next set is here. We got Cloud9 Lightning still. We got Mini and Shellos. So, yeah. Also, I changed my clothes, of course. It's the basically autumn fall school uniform. So, you know what? It's about that time. It's September. So, let's go. Can't go wrong with that, can ya? I'll actually fight Scizor. I almost said Scizor, but no, it's Scyther. You know, of course. Of course it is. And you know, I'll probably like do this off screen, but like all the like random forms and especially like the stuff from Legends Arceus, I'll just port those Muns over and whatnot, and all that stuff, and everything will be A-okay. Then I'll probably do some editing in the box and make everything organized, and go from there. So yeah, Lightning wants to learn Roost. Why not get rid of Uproar in the process? So boxes 3 through 7 are chock full of Pokemon that need to be evolved. And also, some of them not only have stages, they end up evolving with items as well. So, oh boy. Some are difficult. Case in point, this is why I have 2 Pokemon that I ported from other games. So, yeah. Okay. I guess for some reason the other Pokemon haven't... Some Pokemon are, like, really close to leveling up. The other ones can probably take a bit of time. Because I was trying to be like, oh no, these Pokemon have to be right before the number where they evolve. So, the pace might be a little meh in the beginning, but things will skyrocket as we go, I hope. Don't you do that. How dare you paralyze my Pokemon, you banana-wearing, flying grass creature. Alright. Hey! Cloud9 wants to evolve. By all means, Cloud9. Go right ahead. Altaria is here. The beautiful cloud bird is humming in our ear and registered to our decks. On sunny days, it flies freely through the skies and blends into the clouds. It sings in a beautiful soprano. Alright. Dragon Pulse. Everybody else is learning, so why can't you? Round. Alright, good job. Hey, Shellos. We already have your other form, and mostly thanks to the events. Aha! Oh-ho, hee-hee, ha-ha! Gastrodon is here. Let's go and face the duck. The gold duck. That's actually blue. Okay, psychic it up. Slowking. Yes. Oh no, not the hydro pump. Anything but the hydro pump. Well, not everything. We don't want, like, Oblivion Wing and whatever Ultra Necrozma can do. You know. Ah, yes, there we go. The bird is evolving. Yay. How wonderful, terrific, amazing, awesome. This should have evolved back when we caught it. Kilowattrel is here. Yay. Good job, Lightning. Good job. It uses its throat sac to store electricity generated by its wings. There's hardly any oil in its feathers, so it is a poor swimmer. I can see that. Alright. Another one wants to learn a move. Electro Ball? Let's give the gift that keeps on giving and get rid of Spark. Okay. Hey! Gulp. You want to evolve too, huh? Alright, well, Gulp will evolve. Swalot is here. Aren't you a big boy? Not Snorlax big, but you know. Something for you, and I'm glad you evolved. It can swallow a tire whole in one gulp. It secretes its a horrible toxic fluid from the pores on its body. But you're still such a lovable oaf. Yay, another one down, another one down. Body slam it up. Yeah, sure. amnesia. Goodbye, bye. Every time you guys learn a new move, I'm gonna say yes. You know? Why not? Yeah, for some reason, a lot of the Pokemon I have cannot, for whatever reason, battle a lot of the Pokemon that are in the water. So I've been standing on land, basically defeating Scythers and Tropiuses and other Pokemon. I mean, occasionally the water, yeah. But, you know, mostly a land lover for what it's worth. We'll probably branch off as the Muns get some time. And, oh yeah. Okay, who's ready? Marini the Meanie wants to evolve, by all means. The more the merrier. Toxapec, well, aren't you a sight for sore eyes? You brutal star Pokemon, you. Toxapec gets into fierce battles with Ruxish over areas where warm ocean currents flow, but the odds are always against it. Aw, you'll always be my favorite, Toxapec. Baneful Bunker. Okay. Pin Missile. Ta-da! Still got Snappy, Manchester, Needle, and Roar. Add to the rank. And let's give some love to Scizor while we're at it. Oh, yeah. All right. I don't have to be shy and keep off of Maridon, do I? No. There you are in all your shiny red glory. All right. Now that's the way, I like it. I don't know why I said that, but you know, Pokemon makes you do weird shenanigans, and shenanigans it is, indeed. Okay, hey Manchester, the regular Johto Wooper wants to evolve. So by all means, let's evolve it into the big, smiley, weird-eyed creature known as Quagsire, not Clodsire. Scyther, I see you. Prepare yourself for a duel of your family tree. It's like deja vu. You're like, oh, gasp, older brother. Well, technically, I wouldn't say older brother, but younger brother. Because Scyther has been out longer than Scyther by just one generation, so, you know what, yeah. And then Cleaver is their younger brother. Or maybe, I don't know. Because it's technically a distant relative or something. So it's like a great-great-great relative or something like that. You know, it gets weird. Our pink little elephant pal, Tusky, which I'm surprised I didn't evolve during the playthrough of earlier points. Donphan! You will like your new form, my young elephant pal. Good on ye. Donphan is normally a calm Pokemon, but once it is enraged, it will curl its body into a ball and charge at you while rolling. I miss those days when you could I could do the same thing. No. Yeah, I actually learned how to roll into a ball at one point because of Donphan, so yeah. Fury attack? Hey. Let's endure the fury attack. Okay. Since some people want to fight. Hey, I guess we got a little sushi fish that wants to battle. Tatsugiri, let's get to getting. Ooh, not quite. Not bad, though. Not bad. With that X scissor. No, not the Dragon Balls. Right to the face. Haha. Tatsugiri has fainted. You did marvelous. Flamethrower for Roar. Well, by all means, go right ahead. Don't know why I have Roar with me, but, you know, I have a weird obsession with catching them all, and including the gender differences and the region differences, so, yeah. By all means, why not? Okay. And... ooh, Keknia! I mean, Needle is evolving! Good on ye. Kekturn? Not something you would want to see at night, so it's a good thing you're evolving in the day. But do you really want to see this in the day, too? I mean, I'm sure it's still lovable. It lives in deserts. It becomes active at night when it hunts for prey, exhausted from the desert's heat. Aw. Yeah, it's probably better to go in the desert in the night when it's actually cooler out instead of really hot, but you still can't see in the night, so it's a win-win situation in ways. Spiky Shield. Ingrain. No longer is necessary for you. My friend. Hey, Roar. Rah. Alright. The female Pyroar is here. Rocky is evolving. Roly-poly. Let's go, Rocky. The Carcoal. This is one of the Pokemon that went over its level to evolve. The others being the mighty fierce Pokemon like the dragons that will be coming very, very soon. Just to keep you on your toes. Okay, due to the coal tar created inside it, the heap of coal on Carcoal's back never falls apart. Even when the Pokemon rolls around at high speeds. Ooh, scary. No, it's not scary. It's lovable in some way. Flame charge. Alright. Let's take care of rock polish. Gotta polish those rocks somehow, but, you know. Flame charge, I guess. Alright. So, Scizor, still looking mighty fine as always. Snappy, Rocky, Sandy, Sandstream, and Tuskington are ready for anything. Yes. Oh, yeah. Scizor might need some healing after this. Or whatnot, but, you know. Can never be too careful. I keep saying scissor instead of scissor, but you know. I miss the old days when certain Pokemon were easy to remember their names. Now it's such like, Oh, what's that Pokemon's name? Or something. That's mostly... It's not so much the past generation as it is the new generation, but, you know. Venomoth? Okay. Yeah. Alright. Venomoth it is. You can't do anything to me, because I'm steel. Haha. Take that, you bugger of a weird bug. Okay, I knew ye be evolving, Snappy. Snap to it. Chop chop. Yes, yes. Oh yeah. Clawinsa. With your big claw that may either have a powerful punch to it or a lot of tasty meat. But don't let Clawinsa hear you say that. The cannonballs of seawater that Clawinsa launches from its claw are powerful enough to punch through tanker hulls. Yeah, I wouldn't want that to my face or any vital organs. So, yeah. Oh, yeah. No, no, no. Well, Maridon, where to next? Where to next? The water? You really want to give it a go, huh? All right. Well, where's those tasty little mons? Gyarados? Oh, no. You want to go on this big old destructive dragon, don't you? That's not actually a dragon. It has dragon syndrome, but it's not actually a dragon. And I don't think we're actually perfect for this at all, because the moves aren't effective at all. But it doesn't really matter, because you're going to have to level up after this, but still. You know, Scizor, you'll get a... You'll get it. Alright. Good. Thank you. You have to recharge. Haha, Gyarados. You think you're mighty strong. I mean, you did help out in the beginning of the playthrough when we caught you. Way back when. So, yeah. Okay. One more attack should do the trick. And it's because it will actually do the trick. If only I had, like, a bazillion ways to level up Pokemon without actually having to battle, but you know me, I've run dry on most of that stuff, so, oh yeah. Not to mention, some of the battle items that I was gonna originally use for the Elite Four are gone because of this kind of training, so... Kind of pays off in some way, shape, or form. Rocky wants to evolve. At last, Rocky gets to see its full potential as the mighty colossal giant creature. Good on ye. It's gentle, usually, but fearsome when angered, with a body that burns at over 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit. It crushes foes and turns them to ash. You know, there's times where I forget. It's like 2,700, whatever. Or 2,000, whatever, you know. Tar shot. Yeah, let's give a shot to Ancient Power. You out of here. Colossal wants its new move. We can always give moves. Sandstream. Alright. You little hippo, you. Turn into that giant hippo. Right, you're the male Hippowdon, so alright. Good job. Very good. You heavyweight, you. It brandishes its gaping mouth in a display of fearsome strength. It raises vast quantities of sand while attacking. That's not something you want to see every day. In front of your face. Get all that sand in your mouth. Tuskington is evolving now. Aww. Very, very cute. Very, very cute. Rawr. That's not how you do it. Kaparaja. It's good to see ya. Kaparaja are prideful, cantankerous Pokemon. Specimens with vibrant green skin command the respect of others of their kind. Cool. Very cool, Kaparaja. Thank you, Fint. Heavy slam! Come on and slam and welcome to the jam. I can't believe I just said that. Rock Smash. Okay, Rock Smash. Hey, what's this, Maridon? Did we just switch places from the water just a second ago? Now we're on land? Alright. Scyther, you are the opponent. But not just any opponent. You will face the one, the only, Big Mac. Because Filet-O-Fish was on back order. So, Dandozo, yeah, living large, very extra large. Avalanche, we had to give you. So yes, I figured out a name. I think it was like Splish Splash or Splashy Fish or something. So Big Mac is now its new name. So yay. And sand is evolving. Get your sandy little nose nostrils into bigger nose nostrils. I actually like the female Hippowdon's color more, even though it's just generic, but you know, it's me. There's some female evolution colors that I like more than the male, and male, yeah, you know. Voltorb, I mean, Thunderball is evolving. So let's let it evolve into a bigger ball with its colors reversed and eyebrows. And a smile. Electrode. It explodes in response to even minor stimuli. It is feared with the nickname of the Bomb Ball. Oh man. Now our next set of Pokemon are here. Nova, Automize, Hongo, Piney, Gully. Sadly, Echo, our good little Delphin. I gotta figure out how to get it to evolve and all that, and I believe you have to go to the Poke Portal and have people join you as a group, and then you show off your Delphin in front of them, and then it becomes pals with it. So yeah, that's basically how you evolve it, and I gotta figure out how to make friends. So if you're watching and you have the game, let's be friends. Please. Here we go. And I'm surprised a dragon is affected by a dragon. Order up sushi! On the go! Good job, good job. Good job, big fish. You want to learn agility? Well, okay, Supersonic has to go bye-bye then. Gully. You silly Wingull, you. Hey, look who's evolving, Gully. Good golly, Gully is evolving. Helper. Yay. You water bird. You, it protects its young in its beak. It bobs on waves, resting on them on days when the waters are calm. Ooh. Nice. And now we can show off. Everything is okay. We got Heck, our Houndour, with us. So let's go and get Scyther all cut up and avalanched to get some experience. Oh yeah. Some you actually can defeat, some you can't for some reason. It's like that. You use an ice move against a bug. Some of them survive, some of them don't. It's odd. I guess they have like defense in some ways. I'm pretty sure that has something to do with it, not the leveling. Heck, you're evolving! Good boy. Good doggy. Here's your treat. Houndoom! The Hound of Hell. I mean, Heck. Upon hearing it, eerie howls, other Pokemon get the shivers and head straight back to their nests. Yeah, that would be wise to do. Houndoom is on the prowl and in charge. Large and in charge. Hey, you Trapius, wake up. I saw you sleeping there. It's showtime. It is very much showtime. And we got a show for you today. Oh, joy. Oh, boy, Trapius. Oh, yes. We got quite the show. Hey, Hungo, you want to evolve? By all means, become a bigger mushroom creature. Amoongus. Yeah, Amoongus mimics Pokeballs. It is not yet clear whether this mimicry is effective against other Pokemon. Well, if Zora and Zorax is, I'm sure the mushrooms work. Piney! Mushrooms and pine cones. Pine cones and mushrooms. Fortress! How are you, Fortress? You're all shiny. It's like steel types are really shiny in this generation. Or it's just me. Its entire body is shielded by a steel-hard shell that lurks inside. Its shell is a total mystery. What lurks inside its shell is a total mystery indeed. Indeed it is. Indeed it is. Piney wants to learn the move Heavy Slam. By all means, Piney can learn whatever it wants to learn. Curse, go away. Good on ya, Piney. Heart is evolving. Yeah. Good job, Heart. You are now a very cool looking Barracuda. Not the best fish, but you know, you're interesting. It swims at speeds of over 100 knots and battles fiercely with pods of Finizen over prey. Ooh, we still gotta evolve Finizen then. Oh, we will eventually. And we must continue. We must continue indeed. For it is fine with us. And I just realized we do not have a Goomy. So, we gotta catch that Goomy. You know, might as well. It's here. We're here. So, catch away. Shall we? You can curse me all you want. I'm still gonna become your master. Eventually. So, yeah, we don't wanna do any of that. So let's just keep ultra balling until you finally get into said ultra ball and become our best friend, Goomy. Oh yeah, Goomy, wise choice, wise Very wise choice. Aha. Excellent. Very excellent, Gumi. Soft tissue Pokemon, Gumi's horns are excellent sensory organs that cover all five of Gumi's senses. Gumi picks up on danger from the movement of the air. Alright, Gumi, welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And hey, Finny wants to evolve. All that goom wants Finny to evolve, so it's worth it. Luminion is here. Now it's Neon Glory. Luminion swimming in the darkness of the deep seas. Looks like star shining in the night sky. Nice. Shovel wants to evolve. Well, Shovel can get what it wants. As long as it has a shovel, which it does. Hello there, Palossand. Don't get a little too mushy because it's kind of snowing. It's not snowing. Raining. Wrong weather, Shadow. From the hollows in its arms, it fires the bones of its victims, which are all dried up after being drained of their vitality. Ooh. That's ghost types for you, though. Scary. And we're actually back up on the actual upper mountain, which really we were pretty much just down on the other part of it. So, yeah. Scyther. Dondozo, I mean Big Mac. Avalanche! Avalanche indeed. Goes a long way. And you know what? Might as well just keep Gumi in here just to get it to evolve. And it's raining, so that's a plus. Nova! I love you. You're like one of the coolest bugs ever. Larvesta, ShadowHarvester, it all matches. Volcarona! Oh yeah. Sun Pokemon. This Pokemon scatters burning scales. Most of the danger of these scales is not in their heat. It's in the way they rob the surrounding air of oxygen. Oh boy. That's one mighty Pokemon. No wonder they're mostly in runes and stuff. Quiver Dance. You can dance if you want to, but you know, I wouldn't sing that either. Yeah, something something safety dance. Just be safe. Here we go. Another very not so crazy battle that's gonna turn crazy in one way or another. I'm not surprised that I said nutty. It's gonna turn in the beginning, but you know, hey, why not? Automize. Vroom 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 vroom. Engines. Oh yeah, you did well, Revavroom. You did well. Okay. Revavroom viciously threatens others with the sound of its exhaust. It sticks its tongue out from its cylindrical mouth and sprays toxic fluids. No wonder a certain team decided to use one. Well, good job, Vroom Vroom and Revavroom. Gear shift, okay, or shift gear, whatever. Yep, headbutt is going bye bye. You don't have much of a head butt. But, I mean, if you've ever seen a car slam into another car or something, yeah. Try wants to evolve. By all means, try can definitely evolve. Magneton is here. They're formed by several Magnemite linked together. They frequently appear when sunspots flare up. Okay. Well, we don't have magnetic ruins, canyons, mountains in this generation, but you do evolve in another certain way, so that's probably what we're gonna head off and do. Tri-attack. Alright, well, tri-attack. Try this on for size, replacing Screech. Alright. And yes, we got a Thunderstone for you to evolve, try. So, don't think we didn't forget about you, because we will never be able to forget about you. Magnezone. It is on in this zone right about here. Sonic isn't the only one that takes care of zones. Exposure to a special magnetic field changed Magneton's molecule structure, turning it into Magnezone. Okay. Yeah. Slowpoke does. Slowpoke is ready for battle. And ready for battle it will be. Let's order up some sushi for this little ditz of a Pokemon. But you can't get wrong with that. I mean, Slowbro, Slowking, and their Galarian counterparts. Oh yeah. Psychic! Hold in there, Big Mac! Order up, Big Mac! Oh yeah! Okay. Not bad, not bad, not bad. Awesome. But we still got some more stuff to go, and some of these Pokemon didn't get a lot of experience, so yeah. Let's just do this, and you know what? Dondozo, I think you need some health and whatnot, so we'll definitely heal you up, big guy. We will definitely heal you up. Okay, we are definitely off. Tropius faces Mew. Yes, the Mew we got in the event. So, yeah. Okay. Nice. Very, very nice. Okay. Hey, Arctic. Yay. You little snot-nosed bear, you. Give us a hug. Beartick. Welcome, Beartick. Welcome. Feared as the snow-white demon in northern lands, Beartick uses its frosty claws and fangs to attack prey. I never heard Beartick be known as a snow-white demon, but hey, I believe it. I believe it. Good job, Beartick. Icicle Crash. Well, let's crash the hopes and dreams of Charm. And I don't mean from Legends Arceus. Okay. Alright. Let's evolve some stuff. Hurry up and evolve some stuff, you know. It doesn't help that I delay everything and then it becomes a, like a I assumed we were gonna have quite the fun. Jeez, all these scythers coming everywhere. Holy cow. Holy moly. Holy. Scyther galore. Which Muse Ice Beam will do wonders upon. And I mean wonders upon. Also, I'm training up Mew because, well, there happens to be a Mewtwo raid battle which we may or may not win, so yeah. Who knows? Okay, alright. Hey, who wants to evolve now? Goomy? I knew having you with us would help you. Good job, my gooey little pal. And it stopped raining, sadly. Sligoo. Soft tissue Pokemon. When Sligoo senses danger, the mucus coating in its entire body becomes more concentrated. It'll dissolve anything. Sounds like pickles falling on the floor and dissolving paint because of the acid. That totally does not destroy you. Curse, go away. Alright. Ice Beam on Tropius, Mew. If you please. I apologize if this is probably boring, but you know. It's just me. Gotta do what you gotta do. Business is business. Snome! Who evolves with high friendship at night. Snome. Icy, you are on par with what you are called. You are cold as ice, but you have a warm heart. And that's all that matters. Frostmoth, good to see ya. Glad we got you from that one fellow. It causes blizzards as it flies around with its huge, chill, intimidating wings. Clean melt water is its favorite thing to drink. Can't argue with that. A drink is a drink, no matter how weird it is. Icy deserves the wind. Yeah. Okay. More Tropius, more fun to be had. Let's go. Let's go indeed. Yeah, the button stopped, so someone's evolving. Seeker, good job. And you were one of those Pokemon that I overleveled when it came to getting its right proportions. So, Dracloak. Welcome. This Pokemon stores up energy in its lungs, then shoots it out. It takes care of Dreepy and battles alongside them until they're all grown up. You mean fires them at opponents. Especially after it evolves. So it's probably like all cared about, and then when it finally evolves, it just shoots them out for fun. Yeah. I get that. I get it. Very much. I don't get it at all. Dragon Pulse for a Dragon Pokemon. These Dragon Pokemon can be ruthless to level up. Well, so can any Pokemon that has like 50 or almost 60 to evolve. So, yeah. Hey, Hetrim. You want to evolve too? Well, why not? Why not indeed? It's a Pokemon, but this is not what I mean. Hetrin. Hey. Beware of forests that show no signs of living creatures within. You may have wandered into Hetrin territory. Ooh. Spooky. Psycho Cut. And we want to get rid of Sidebeam? All right. Fine with us. Also, I think another Pokemon of ours needs the sun, of course, so we gotta wait for that. And as long as we keep battling or whatnot, it should make the sun go. Because I know in Sword and Shield, it took a while for the sun to come up. You really like doing this, huh, Mew? I'm so sorry, Mew. I am so sorry. I love you. Sliggoo? Let's battle. You're here. You're here for a purpose, so... yeah. We gotta just wait for it to rain, and we gotta wait for it to shine, and... you know. Okay. Not bad, not bad. Anybody? Tropius. Prepare to get your banana cut up and turn into some sort of smoothie. You'll be fine though, but give us the banana. The potassium we need to level up and evolve and go well with Krogunk. Krogunk. Yeah, it's ready for evolution. Toxicroak is here. That's probably the only time I'll ever be excited for it, Krogunk or Toxicroak, but you know. It has a poison sac in its throat. So does another Pokemon. Surprise, surprise. When it croaks, the stored poison it's churned for greater potency. That's dangerous. Mighty dangerous. I see you over here. Yes, you. Okay. Now we gotta hurry up, because there's some Pokemon that it's like, I gotta remember, it's like, some evolve in the day, some evolve during weather, some evolve, of course, during the night. And since it is the night, we gotta, you know, be on our toes. Be on our very, very, very odd toes. And with holding the razor claw at night, Sneasel evolves. So good on ya, Claw. Good on ya. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Weavile. They travel in groups of four or five, leaving signs for one another on trees and rocks. They bring down their prey with coordinated attacks. Nice. Very nice. Okay, back in the bag we are. Ice Stone, let's go. And evolve Crabrawler. Crab legs, you no longer have to wait to be unevolved by going into some snowy mountain area. No. Crabominable. Ah! Alright, registered and going through its punches are powerful, this Pokemon. Movements are sluggish, it blows icy bubbles from its mouth to immobilize opponents. Well, you are a bumble of a bumble. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer reference right there. And I'm glad I made that. Ice Punch! Ice Punch, I bet you make some good punch. All you have to do is just stand there and like, okay, it's frozen. So, icy cubes and all that stuff, so, yay. And we got another Ice Stone for Pokemon that I am surprised took forever to do. Glacier is here. Glacier. Glacier, whatever I want to say. Cetitan, welcome. You're one of those Pokemon I actually enjoyed when Scarlet and Violet were announced. I'm not gonna lie. You are a fun Terra Whale of a Pokemon. Ice energy builds up in the horn on its upper jaw, causing the horn to reach cryogenic temperatures that freeze its surroundings. Nice. That also reminds me of something, and we're gonna do that right away. Okay. So, we don't really actually have to do this, but there's a new event and a code. So, yeah, we're going to take care of that. So, apparently, something called Paldean Winds has some episode thing, and to celebrate its release, a Pokemon that is found in said episode of, like, a special anime thing that they made, which runs until August 31st of next year, and we're going to grab a hold of it. So, where's that? Okay. And, one of these, one of these, one of those. Okay, like a flute should be the way to go. And we don't really need this Pokemon, since it is a Pokemon we technically already just got ourselves with the Ice Stone, which is a Cetitan, but it's an event and we're still going for it. All right, nothing wrong with that. So yeah, and any more reason to go for this cool looking Pokemon that many may not use. Okay, that's not something I expected the moment I went back into recording. my ear feels like it has something in it. But, you know, it's not as bad as Scyther's weird ear getting ice beamed. So, it's a win-win. Alright. Axew! Hello! You evolve! Yes! Very, very nice. Fracture! You will be whole again. You will no longer be fractured. Fracture uses its thick tusks to neatly cut prey into two portions, one to eat now and one to save for later. Ooh. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, the thing with the ear makes my voice sound a little weird. So Flo evolves, of course, leveling up in the daytime. So yay. Yay, yay, yay. I'm gonna have to go hunt down some rain for Gudra. So Lurantis, an old totem Pokemon from the Alola region. That isn't a totem Pokemon at all. Or from the Alola region this time around. But still fun. A lot of time and effort is required to maintain the vivid colors of its petals. This Pokemon puts its trainer's attentiveness to the test. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Petal Blizzard. Alright, Petal Blizzard it is. Let's get rid of synthesis. So, yeah. Okay. Alright, next up on the Pokemon list, with a Water Stone, we go with Shellder. Clamp is ready. Yeah, stick that tongue out, because it's going to get cut off and replaced, which essentially just looks like a Ghastly is inside of a clam shell. So, yeah. Alright, Cloyster is here. When attacked, it launches its spikes in quick volleys. Its innards have never been seen. I'm seeing it right now. I see it smiling at me. Don't tell me those eyes and mouth are not its innards. So, Icicle Spear. Leer, go bye-bye. Go bye-bye now. Yes. Okay, back in the bag we are. Shiny stone, and you down here are ready to evolve. Bloom. Let's bloom it up with bloom. Okay. Yeah. Bloom is ready to become Florges. You are a gorgeous Florges. You garden Pokemon, you. And you are a red flower. They say that flower gardens created by Florges are constantly showered with a power that can heal both body and spirit. Relaxing. Very, very, very touching and very relaxing. Oh, yeah. Alright, so this next little area, it's more of a scavenger hunt, and we have to go all the way up this mountain. And, yeah. Now, we could literally go and grab it at the auction house on a certain specific day where we found the one gym leader's wallet. But, yeah. Luckily, you can find something just out here in the wide yonder open. So that's a-okay with us, right? And we're still literally right there by the lake. So there's always that. I did not mean to do that. I did not mean to do that. How unprofessional of me. So, right here, where, we do not run into more Pokemon on the way. Luckily, there's a run button. So, before I was rudely interrupted, we are going right over here where the grass switches its color. And, yep. Let's grab a hold of this mountain. And you can literally see where the little flag is pointing. Now, I don't know why I am going like this, but we at the Zorcarat Trail. And, we are going to stop flying because, well, you know. And then right here where this waterfall leads, we are going to go this way. And we're here, and I believe this is it. I had to actually look this up in a video, the cracked pot item. Someone was making this video, but they were talking like so fast and that stuff, and it was kind of hard to pay attention to their voice instead of the video, but hey, we made it. Okay, the cracked pot item is here, so our little teacup can evolve. It's tea time with Sinistea. Oh yeah. Okay. Woo! Poltegeist is here. But tea time still stands with the black tea phony form Pokemon. We can probably get the other one. I'll probably even go back and into Sword and Shield to get one. These Pokemon multiply by creeping into teapots, pouring themselves into leftover tea. Don't you go in my tea. You can go right next to me and drink some tea, and then we can have fun. Yes, it's tea time, all right. Forget that move with sweet scent as the culprit of the tea time scandal. And hey, it's the Pokemon that is fun to, I guess, battle against or something. This was also one of those Pokemon that bullied Mew, like everything, and Wide Guard. So you know I did a lot of Swift, why this thing did Wide Guard. So that's how I figured out that apparently Wide Guard can block Swift's attacks. So Yeah. Grimer is evolving. The sludge gets sludgier. But it also becomes warm and sympathetic and gives you a big slappy hug. It's just like Ash Ketchum's muck in the anime. It's so stinky! Muck's body contains toxic elements and any plant will wilt when it passes by. Oh no! Oh no! And what better way to do more bag stuff than grab the Pokemon that evolves with the Sunstone? No, I'm not talking about Gloom into Blossom. It's Petili into Lilligant. Oh yeah! Lily, let's power you up. Let's power you up into a nice, sweet, cute Lilligant. You know of a form, of course, not the Hisuian. So yeah. No matter how much time and money is spent raising it, its flowers are the most beautiful when they bloom in the wild. If only all plants were like that, especially food plants, like vegetables and fruits. So yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh yeah. And Petal Dance is the thing you want to learn. Charm, go away. Don't come back another day. Or maybe you do. And we're already in the battle with the next Mon of the Hour. It's a more flamingo fun up here, rare to go, and if you listen closely, you can hear me constantly clicking to enlarge and dis-unlarge my you-know-what. So, yeah. Alright, absolutely. Let's learn Blizzard Absolute Zero. Let's get rid of the Recover. The Recover no more. Which we always have to recover. But that's what Nurse Joy is for. Absolute Zero. Which you are a very big hero. Not a zero. But since you're an ice type, it makes sense to call you that because of the weather, chill, of cold air, and you get my point. Avalug, welcome. Welcome, welcome. This Pokemon uses its massive ice body to flatten anything that gets in its way. When it's floating out on the ocean, it looks exactly like drift ice. Yeah. Yeah, welcome. Body slam? Well, alright. Takedown? Get out of here. We don't want you anymore. Oh yeah, Tropius. I'm still serious. Give those bananas to us. Now. Or pay the price. Honestly, that camera is a little weird. It's fun that we can actually do what we can do with it, but you know, certain Pokemon need to be certain sizes. Drake is evolving. Congratulations, you will become the main Mon of the Hoenn Elite Four Dragon Master Shelgon is here. It's armor, whatever, whatever. Okay. We knew I was gonna mess that up eventually. Protect. Well, we did say one move, and we don't really need protect, but a promise is a promise, and sometimes I have to keep it, sometimes I don't. Scyther! Yeah, you can see Scyther and Tropius are the most common Pokemon for me to do this, so... yeah. Okay. Alright. Hey, don't go to sleep now. You still need that potassium, big boy. Ice beam to the face. Because I like that. I like that a lot. It's not funny to get it in the face, but I didn't expect to see another Travius so soon. But, you know, same as the... It's got to be like 500 Travius's at this point or something. Not in this video, but, you know. It's crazy. Someone's evolving. Bobo. It's evolving into a Gatorita. Using its psychic power, it arranges pebbles to form the shapes of constellations. Some people believe this Pokemon came from outer space. It's a Deoxys in disguise! Or Ultra Beast, or any other Pokemon that comes from space. Hey, holy cow, look at all these pink little birds. Ready for action. Oh yeah, we gotta go for that. It's a bargain sale on these flamingos. They're running away though. That's the problem. They love to run, but they can never hide from the power I possess. And like I said, that camera. Some Pokemon are in sight, and then, like, Dandozo. It's just like, huh? Where the heck is it? And all that other wide guarding, and all that other fascinating stuff. So, yeah. We're gonna run out of, you know, soon, but oh well. Who's evolving? Okay, Snover. I actually like Snover, I'm not gonna lie. It's one of those Pokemon that you come across, but then you forget to never use it again, and then it evolves into the abominable snow monster that it is. They appear when the snow flowers bloom. When the petals fall, they retreat to places unknown again. So they're known, but they're not unknown, and they're unknown, and all that other tearjerker of a stuff. So Ice Punch, go Swagger, give us something good to eat. Go for it, you pink little flamingo dancing. Looking-aware type of person. I don't know what I'm saying. You know? And, yeah. Got dragons upon dragons. Noibat is evolving! Good job, Echoes. The sound is good with thee. Noivern is here. Ain't it a beauty? It is a beauty. Sound waves galore. In the dark, even Hydreigon are terrified of this Pokemon. But in the light, Noivern is the one that avoids battle. It does. Sound waves are everything. Dragon Pulse? I don't see why not. Tailwind? Get out of here. Okay. Good job. Oh, we ran into a Slowpoke that needs to have a battle. So let's battle it. Shall we? Rain Dance, that would help immensely if that actually worked to evolve Pokemon after the battle. But you know, they're just getting out of choosers and all that other shenanigans again. Okay. Yeah. Let's see who's close to leveling themselves. Oh, hey, Gibble. Gibble. Why not?
Gabite.
Good job, Gabite. You're almost there. It loves sparkly things. It seeks treasures in caves and hoards the loot in its nest. Fancy, fancy, right? Must have a really good nest. Okay, at long last, rain is here. Rain is here. And I forgot to heal up Mew. I promise Mew, after this one battle, or a few battles, whatever. I think one of the Pokemon has a rare candy attached to them in the box, which I should have grabbed. we'll figure that out in some other fashion. I'll probably search it by the end of this video, which this video might be a little long. So deal with it. Deal with it. We're getting there. We're getting there. We got the dragons. That's like the biggest hurdle. So, yeah. Oh, yeah. Literally all dragons. None the wiser. Fracture is ready to go and be awesome. Haxorus. It overwhelms enemies with its prized tusks, which are sharp enough to cut through a metal transmission tower in one strike. You gotta be kidding me. It stopped raining. Ah! Okay, so here we are. We're gonna use the Firestone on Eevee. Number one, get ourselves a nice fiery Flareon, of course. of course. And with this, we'll, of course, complete the evolutions. Thank you, Pokemon Legends Arceus, for giving me the Eevees, because it was a pain in the butt to find them in this area. These areas, I mean. So when you're looking for Pokemon, it's different. But when you actually play the game and don't do anything, you find anything. It fluffs out its fur collar to cool down its body temperature, which can reach 1,650 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, whatever. If I say it right, I say it right. I say it wrong, I say it wrong. It's me. Got that? Ember. And the only reason you're the Flareon is because your Terra type is fire, so yeah. Calm mind can go bye-bye. The Thunderstone for sweet Jolteon is upon us. Yes. Take it in, little one. Take it in. Because soon we'll have them all. Yay. If agitated, it uses electricity to strain out its fur and launch it in small bunches. Effective? Very effective. Very effective indeed. Thundershock. Alright, let's get rid of the charm. Okay, and the leaf stone's just right here. I'm not gonna lie, finding these items in the Delibird shop in the main academy city is a pain in the butt to find. So yes, the leaf stone, we don't have to look for a moss rock or any ice rocks or whatever. These evolutions come with the same as every other one. Leafeon! Good to see you again after Sword in the preliminary first set of battles from the Pokemon League type of tournament thing. The younger they are, the more they smell like fresh grass. With age, their fragrance takes on the odor of fallen leaves. Of course, it wasn't just Pokemon's sword. We've seen Leafeon probably in every playthrough I've done so far. So, yeah. The magic kind of wears it off, the novelty. Razor Leaf. Charm again. Also, I did find the culprit with the rare candy. It was none other than Quagsire, our Manchester. Shame, shame, shame. And with that, more Scyther stuff. Oh yeah, you know me. Never a dull moment. Never a dull moment, and I got a whole lot of stuff to edit. Like, hooey. Okay, Toxicroak, hello. Hello, hello. And of course, after this, goodbye, Toxicroak. But you will never be forgotten, and you will live on in my box as a croaking good croaker. So, yes. Okay. At least you're willing to get taken out. And alright. Alright. Haha. Slasher. My pony art is evolving. These Pokemon are actually from Box 7. So, yeah. We're there. Goodra is literally the only other Pokemon we need. And Sliggoo needs rain. Bisharp is here. King Gambit can be proud. Voyage, our Galarian Meowth. Oh yeah. Gonna get some Berserker up in here. Woohoo! Nice. Iron Head. Why not? Payday. Go bye bye. Because we already paid for the day. Okay, I take back what I said about... Sliggoo being the last of its kind. Alright, we're in the bag because it's raining outside. Rare candy, I'm not missing this chance. And I did lie and say Sliggoo, now Goodra, is the last Pokemon to evolve that's not in our party. Because we still have Bobo, our Gatherita, to evolve. So, Goodra is here. Yay! Good Goodra. Good pile of goo. You are awesome. You deserve a nice cookie. This Pokemon is uncontrollable when enraged. It rampages on, lashing its tail with enough power to send a dump truck flying. Okay, that's a lot of power. Actually, I lied again, because if we still have the dolphin to evolve, but you know that's gonna take forever. So, yay! Aqua Tail. Alright. Acid Spray. Go bye bye. Aha. Okay, to make it fair with the next set of Pokemon, I am actually going to, like, I'm going to battle off screen, but come back when they get closer to their experience. So, the only reason you see me right now is because of that. Because, yes, Bobo is ready to complete its goth phase in its maturest of phases. Gathetel. So yes, it gazes at the stars to predict the future. It acts somewhat detached because it has seen the end of all existence. Dun dun dun. Man, wow, that's deep. Aha! There you are, my pink friend. My other pink friend. Can't forget about Mew. And all the other pink Pokemon. Okay. Aha! Gotcha. It looks like we're gonna have an evolution up in here. Could it be? Yes, Gabite. With the trees in the way. So, yeah. At least we have control of the camera. Some Pokemon apparently have that weird rainbowy background. Others just do it in, like, the actual place. But, you know, hey, whatever. Garchomp is here. Oh, yeah. Garchomp. The protuberance is on its head serve as sensors. It can't even detect distant prey. Well, you need to distinctly find the prey that we need to evolve your next friend. Crunch. Alright, I think you're going to detect a slash getting utterly, utterly destroyed. Scyther! Haha. Okay. Okay, Scyther, prepare to take it all. Oh yeah, couldn't do that before with Mew. No, no, no. And Seeker wants to learn the Dragon Rush. Alright, well, Dragon Rush it up with Quick Attack, feeling the Seeker's wrath. Okay. Let's rush it up with Dragon Rush. And speaking of the Dragon Rush, Seeker is evolving! Is it a bird? Is it a plane? It's some sort of ghost dragon creature. That just likes to be fast. The fastest Dragapult of the group is always surrounded by Dreepy that want to fly at sonic speed. Well, I guess we're the fastest of the Dragapults then. Because we got two. It's not what it means by being surrounded, but you know what? Dragon darts. Let's dart it up with infestation. Getting darted. Oh yeah. Don't worry there, Finizen. My dear sweet Echo, we will find a way to make friends. And you shall evolve. But you'll have to wait and see. I bet you didn't expect to see me in the bag again. Well, going around Paldea in Violet, we have not seen any form of apples fall from the tree. So I decided to go into the good old Galar region with Sword and Shield. And through some vigorous training with my pal, my own Applin evolution, I managed to get two Applin with a Ditto's help in the daycare on Route 5. And we're going to evolve them. So Tart Apple for my dear sweet friend, Noble. Who also was hatched from Noble's sweet help. So, there's that. So, let's hope. Hopefully, these are the right apples. Because that would be weird. Yes, yes, it is. Flapple. Also, these things are at level 1 because they literally hatched and then got sent to Pokemon Home and. Yeah. So. And like I was saying, some Pokemon have this weird background, some just do it right in the field. It uses its own body fluid to repair its apple. Strong Flapple that have won many battles have apples that are clay colored all over. Ooh.
Nice apple wing Pokemon right there. Wing attack. And here we go with the sweet apple. So, who are we going to use it on? Of course, we have no choice to use it on. Good ol' Rayburn. Or however you say that. I was looking up apple names. I wanted to call you Golden Delicious. But it wouldn't fit. Curses. Three letters short for that. So, Appleton, you pie critter, you. Here you are. You apple nectar Pokemon, you. When some Lechonk come along to lick the sweet nectar on Appleton's back, Appleton will spew sticky nectar at them to drive them away. Lechonk, stay away from my Appleton. And you too, Oinkalone, male and female. It's mine. I will never share, even though I don't care for the taste of apple pie. It's like a love-hate relationship. I don't hate it as much. I just don't care for it. Right? Right? Alright. So yeah, welcome to the Dex. And Headbutt. You level 1 you. And this is going to conclude Violet for today. I'm Shadow Harvester. Thanks for watching me play Pokemon Violet. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you the next time we lay eyes on whatever we do in Paldea. Later.